Daily Evening Prayer, Sunday, July 28th, 2024. Lord, I have loved the habitation of your house and the place where your honor dwells. Let us humbly confess our sins to Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And apart from your grace, there is no hope for us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess your faults. Restore all those who are penitent, according to your promises declared to all people in Christ Jesus our Lord, and grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may now live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant to your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins, and serve you with a quiet mind. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was at the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, a world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. O gladsome light, pure brightness of the ever-living Father in heaven, O Jesus Christ, holy and blessed, now as we come to the setting of the sun and our eyes behold the vesper light, we sing your praises, O God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You are worthy at all times to be praised by happy voices, O Son of God, O Giver of life, and to be glorified through all the world. O give thanks unto the Lord, for he is gracious, for his mercy endures forever. O give thanks unto the God of all gods, for his mercy endures forever. O give thanks unto the Lord of all lords, for his mercy endures forever. Who alone does great wonders, for his mercy endures forever. Who by his excellent wisdom made the heavens, for his mercy endures forever. Who laid out the earth above the waters, for his mercy endures forever. Who made the great lights, for his mercy endures forever. The sun to rule the day, for his mercy endures forever. The moon and the stars to govern the night, for his mercy endures forever. Who struck down the firstborn of Egypt, for his mercy endures forever. And brought out Israel from among them, for his mercy endures forever. With a mighty hand and an outstretched arm, for his mercy endures forever. Who divided the Red Sea in two parts, for his mercy endures forever. And made Israel to pass through the midst of it, for his mercy endures forever. But as for Pharaoh and his hosts, he overthrew them in the Red Sea, for his mercy endures forever. Who led his people through the wilderness, for his mercy endures forever. Who smote great kings, for his mercy endures forever. And slew mighty kings, for his mercy endures forever. Sihon, king of the Amorites, for his mercy endures forever. And Og, the king of Bashan, for his mercy endures forever. And gave away their land for an inheritance, for his mercy endures forever. Even for an inheritance, for Israel, his servant, for his mercy endures forever. Who remembered us when we were in trouble, for his mercy endures forever. And delivered us from our enemies, for his mercy endures forever. Who gives food to all flesh, for his mercy endures forever. O give thanks unto the God of heaven, for his mercy endures forever. O give thanks unto the Lord of lords, for his mercy endures forever. By the waters of Babylon we sat down and wept when we remembered you, O Zion. As for our harps, we hung them up upon the trees that are therein. For those who led us away captive required of us a song and melody in our heaviness. Sing us one of the songs of Zion. How shall we sing the Lord's song in the land of our captivity? If I forget you, O Jerusalem, let my right hand forget its skill. If I do not remember you, let my tongue cleave to the roof of my mouth. If I prefer not Jerusalem above my dearest joy. Remember the children of Edom, O Lord, in the day of Jerusalem, how they said, down with it, even to the ground. O daughter of Babylon, wasted with misery, happy shall be the one who rewards you as you have done to us. Blessed shall he be who takes your children and throws them against the stones. I will give thanks to you, O Lord, with my whole heart. Even before the gods will I sing praises to you. I will worship toward your holy temple and praise your name because of your loving kindness and truth. For you have magnified your name and your word above all things. When I called upon you, you heard me and gave me increase of strength. All the kings of the earth shall praise you, O Lord, for they have heard the voice of your mouth. They shall sing of the ways of the Lord. That great is the glory of the Lord. For though the Lord be high, yet he has respect for the lowly. As for the proud, he beholds them from afar. Though I walk in the midst of trouble, yet shall you refresh me. You shall stretch forth your hand upon the furiousness of my enemies, and your right hand shall save me. The Lord shall make good his loving kindness toward me. Your mercy, O Lord, endures forever. Despise not the works of your own hands. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the book of Nehemiah, beginning with the sixth chapter, the first verse. Now, when it was reported to Sanballat, Tobiah, Geshem, the Arab, and the rest of our enemies that I had rebuilt the wall, and that no breach was left in it, although at that time I had not installed the doors and the gates, Sanballat and Geshem sent a message to me saying, "Come, let's meet together at Chephirim in the plain of Ono." But they were plotting to harm me. So I sent messengers to them, saying, "I am doing a great work and am unable to come down. Why should the work stop while I leave it and come down to you?" Then they sent messengers to me four times, worded in this way, and I answered them with the same wording. Then Sanballat sent his servant to me in the same way, a fifth time, with an open letter in his hand. In it was written, "It is reported among the nations, and Gashmu says that you and the Jews intend to rebel. For that reason, you are rebuilding the wall, and you are going to be their king according to these reports. You have also appointed prophets to proclaim in Jerusalem concerning you, a king is in Judah, and now it will be reported to the king according to these reports. So come now, let's consult together." Then I sent a message to him saying, "Nothing like these things that you are saying has been done, but you are inventing them in your own mind, for all of them were trying to frighten us, thinking they will become discouraged with the work and it will not be done. But now, God, strengthen my hands." When I entered the house of Shemaiah, the son of Delaiah, son of Mehetabel, who was confined at home, he said, "Let's meet together in the house of God within the temple, and let's close the doors of the temple, for they are coming to kill you, and they are coming to kill you at night." But I said, "Should a man like me flee? And who is there Like me, who would go into the temple to save his own life? I will not go in. Then I realized that God certainly had not sent him, but he uttered this prophecy against me because Tobiah and Sanballat had hired him. He was hired for this reason, that I would become frightened and act accordingly and sin so that they might have an evil report in order that they could taunt me. Remember my God, Tobiah and Sanballat, in accordance with these works of theirs, and also Noadiah, the prophetess, and the rest of the prophets who are trying to frighten me. So the wall was completed on the 25th of the month of Elul in 52 days. When all our enemies heard about it and all the nations surrounding us saw it, they lost their confidence, for they realized that this work had been accomplished with the help of our God. Also, in those days, many letters went from the nobles of Judah to Tobiah, and Tobiah's letters came to them, for many in Judah were bound by oath to him because he was the son-in-law of Shechaniah, the son of Ara, and his son Jehohanan had married the daughter of Meshulam, the son of Berechiah. Moreover, they were speaking about his good deeds in my presence and were reporting my words to him. And Tobiah sent letters to frighten me. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior. For he has regarded the lowliness of his handmaiden. For behold, from now on all generations will call me blessed, for he that is mighty has magnified me. And holy is his name, and his mercy is on those who fear him throughout all generations. He has shown the strength of his arm. He has scattered the proud in the imagination of their hearts, has brought down the mighty from their thrones, and has exalted the humble and meek. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent empty away. He, remembering his mercy, has helped his servant Israel, as he promised to our fathers, Abraham and his seed forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to St. John, beginning with the 4th chapter, the 27th verse. And at this point, his disciples came, and they were amazed that he had been speaking with a woman. Yet no one said, "What are you seeking?" or "Why are you speaking with her?" So the woman left her water pot and went into the city and said to the people, "Come, see a man who told me all the things that I have done. This is not the Christ, is he?" They left the city and were coming to him. Meanwhile, the disciples were urging him, saying, "Rabbi, eat something." But he said to them, "I have food to eat that you do not know about." So the disciples were saying to one another, "No one brought him anything to eat, did he?" Jesus said to them, "My food is to do the will of him who sent me and to accomplish his work. Do you not say there are still 4 months and then comes the harvest? Behold, I tell you, raise your eyes and observe the fields that they are white for harvest. Already the one who reaps is receiving wages and is gathering fruit for eternal life, so that the one who sows and the one who reaps may rejoice together. For in this case, the saying is true, one sows and another reaps. I sent you to reap that for which you have not labored. Others have labored, and you have come into their labor." Now from that city, many of the Samaritans believed in him because of the word of the woman who testified, "He told me all the things that I have done." So when the Samaritans came to Jesus, they were asking him to stay with them, and he stayed there 2 days. Many more believed because of his word, and they were saying to the woman, "It is no longer because of what you said that we believe, for we have heard for ourselves and know that this one truly is the Savior of the world." And after the 2 days, he departed from there for Galilee, for Jesus himself testified that a prophet has no honor in his own country. So when he came to Galilee, the Galileans received him only because they had seen all the things that he did in Jerusalem at the feast, for they themselves also went to the feast. Therefore, he came again to Cana of Galilee, where he had made the water into wine, and there was a royal official whose son was sick at Capernaum. When he heard that Jesus had come from Judea to Galilee, he went to him and began asking him to come down and heal his son. But he was at the point of death. Then Jesus said to him, "Unless you people see signs and wonders, you simply will not believe." The royal official said to him, "Sir, come down before my child dies." Jesus said to him, "Go, your son is alive." The man believed the word that Jesus spoke to him and went home. And as he was now going down, his slaves met him, saying that his son was alive. So he inquired of them the hour when he began to get better. Then they said to him, "Yesterday at the 11th hour, the fever left him." So the father knew that it was at that hour in which Jesus said to him, "Your son is alive." And he himself believed, and his entire household. This is again a second sign that Jesus performed when he had come from Judea to Galilee. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Lord, now let your servant depart in peace according to your word. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared before the face of all people, to be a light to lighten the Gentiles, and to be the glory of your people Israel. Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was at the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Lord be with you and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. O Lord, show your mercy upon us and grant us your salvation. O Lord, guide those who govern us and lead us in the way of justice and truth. Clothe your ministers with righteousness and let your people sing with joy. O Lord, save your people and bless your inheritance. Give peace in our time, O Lord, and defend us by your mighty power. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and take not your Holy Spirit from us. Almighty and everlasting God, you are always more ready to hear than we to pray, and to give more than we either desire or deserve. Pour down upon us the abundance of your mercy, forgiving us those things of which our conscience is afraid, and and giving us those good things for which we are not worthy to ask, except through the merits and mediation of Jesus Christ our Savior, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. O God, whose Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, triumphed over the powers of death and prepared for us our place in the New Jerusalem, grant that we, who have this day given thanks for his resurrection, may praise you in that city of which he is the light, and where he lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. O God and Father of all, whom the whole heavens adore, let the whole earth also worship you, all nations obey you, all tongues confess and bless you, and men, women, and children everywhere love you and serve you in peace. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O God, the Father, Creator of heaven and earth, have mercy upon us. O God, the Son, Redeemer of the world, have mercy upon us. O God, the Holy Spirit, Sanctifier of the faithful, have mercy upon us. O Holy, Blessed, and Glorious Trinity, one God, have mercy upon us. Remember not, Lord Jesus, our offenses, nor the offenses of our forebears, neither reward us according to our sins. Spare us, good Lord, spare your people, whom you have redeemed with your most precious blood, and by your mercy preserve us forever. Spare us, good Lord, from all evil and wickedness, from sin, from the works and assaults of the devil, from your wrath and everlasting condemnation, good Lord, deliver us. From all blindness of heart, from pride, vanity, and hypocrisy, from envy, hatred, and malice, and from all lack of charity, good Lord, deliver us. From all disordered and sinful affections, and from all this, and from all the deceits of the world, the flesh, and the devil, good Lord, deliver us. From all false doctrine, heresy, and schism, from hardness of heart and contempt of your word and commandments, good Lord, deliver us. From lightning and tempest, from earthquake, fire, and flood, from plague, pestilence, and famine, good Lord, deliver us. From all oppression, conspiracy, and rebellion, from violence, battle, and murder, and from dying suddenly and unprepared, good Lord, deliver us. By the mystery of your holy incarnation, by your holy nativity and submission to the law, by your baptism, fasting, and temptation, good Lord, deliver us. By your agony and bloody sweat, by your cross and passion, by your precious death and burial, good Lord, deliver us. By your glorious resurrection and ascension, by the sending of the Holy Spirit, by your heavenly intercession, and by your coming again in power and great glory, good Lord, deliver us in all times of tribulation, in all times of prosperity, in the hour of death, and in the day of judgment. Good Lord, deliver us. We sinners beseech you to hear us, O Lord God, that it may please you to rule and govern your holy church over us in the right way. And beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to limit all bishops, priests, and deacons with true knowledge and understanding of your word, and that both by their preaching and living they may show it accordingly. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to send forth laborers into your harvest, to prosper their work by your Holy Spirit, to make your saving health known unto all nations, and to hasten the coming of your kingdom. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to give all your people increase of grace to hear your word with humility, to receive it with pure affection, and to bring forth the fruit of the Spirit. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to bring into the way of truth all who have erred and are deceived. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to give us a heart to love and fear you, and diligently to keep your commandments. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to bless and keep all your people. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, that it may please you to rule the hearts of your servant, our national leaders, and all others in authority, that they may do justice and show mercy and walk humbly before you. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To bless and guide all judges, giving them grace to execute justice and to maintain truth. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To bless and keep our armed forces by sea and land and air, and to shield them in all dangers and adversities. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to bless and protect all who serve their communities by their labor and learning. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to give and preserve for us and for others the bountiful fruits of the earth, so that at the harvest we all may enjoy them. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to make wars, to cease in all the world, and to give to all nations unity, peace, and concord. We beseech you, dear good Lord, that it may please you to show mercy on all prisoners and captives, refugees, the homeless and the hungry, and all those who are desolate and oppressed. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To preserve all who are in danger by reason of their work or travel, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To strengthen the bonds of those in holy matrimony, to uphold the widowed and abandoned, and to comfort all whose homes are torn by strife, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To protect the unborn and their parents, and to preserve all women in childbirth, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To care for those who have lost children or face infertility, and to provide for young children and orphans, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To visit the lonely and those who grieve, to strengthen all who suffer in mind, body, or spirit, and to comfort with your strength, and to comfort with your presence those who are failing and infirm, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To support, help, and deliver all who are in danger by reason. To support, help, and deliver all who are in danger, necessity, and tribulation, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To have mercy upon all people, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. That it may please you to give us true repentance, to forgive us all our sin, negligence, and ignorance, and to endue us with the grace of your Holy Spirit, to amend our lives according to your holy word, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To forgive our enemies, persecutors, and slanderers, and to turn their hearts, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To strengthen those who stand, to encourage the faint-hearted, to raise up those who fall, and finally to beat down Satan under our feet, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To grant to all the faithful departed to eternal life and peace, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To grant that we may attain to your heavenly kingdom, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. Son of God, we beseech you to hear us. Son of God, we beseech you to hear us. O Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Grant us you. Have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Grant us your peace. O Christ, hear us. O Christ, hear us. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. O Lord, arise and help us, and deliver us for your name's sake. O God, we have heard with our ears, and our forebears have declared to us the noble works that you did in their days and in the time before them. O Lord, arise and help us, and deliver us for your name's sake. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O Lord, arise and help us, and deliver us for your name's sake. From our enemies, defend us, O Christ. Graciously behold our afflictions. With pity, behold the sorrows of our hearts. And mercifully forgive the sins of your people. With favor, hear our prayers. O Son of David, have mercy upon us. Be pleased to hear us, O Christ. Graciously hear us, O Christ. Graciously hear us, O Lord Christ. Let us pray. Look mercifully, O Father, on our infirmities, and for the glory of your name, rescue us from all those evils we now endure. And grant that in all our troubles, we may put our whole trust and confidence in your mercy, serving you in holiness and purity of life, to your honor and glory, through our only mediator and advocate, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. Ere we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise. Not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to show us We're walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, and with you and the Holy Spirit, be honor and glory throughout all ages. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications to you, and you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will grant their requests. Fulfill now, Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen.